Never say God.
God
is a cheerful giver. He loves a cheerful giver. Because he's a cheerful giver. In that book of John 3, verse 16, the Bible says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever will believe in him will inherit eternal life." This means if God could give his only begotten Son so that you and I may inherit eternal life, this means God is a cheerful giver. In that book of 1 Corinthians chapter 9, 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 6, the Bible says, "But this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and he who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. So let each one give as he purposes in his heart, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver." This is time for Christmas. It is time to give cheerfully, not sparingly. If you are blessed and you bless others, your blessing will multiply. Have you pondered why many people's blessing does not multiply? Because if you are blessed and you bless others, your blessing will multiply. The primary reason why God bless us financially, materially, is to share with others. If you continue to give what you don't need, you continue to receive what you don't need. What are those things you don't need? Those things that cannot meet our needs. If you give cheerfully, if you give what your life depends on, God will continue to give you what you need the most, what your life needs most. Many people way coming before God against other outings. You should know that your spiritual life is more important than any other thing in this world. When it is time to go to church, many people rationalize between going to church or attending other business. Even if your loved one is sick in hospital or in a coma, your going there on a Sunday instead of going to church cannot change anything, because you are not the healer. God is the only reason, is the only reason for living. He's the only reason you are alive today. So your relationship with him should not be compared, should not be shared with any other thing. When you give, you are celebrating Christ's giving spirit. When you give in this season, you are celebrating that spirit of giving. Because the Bible says this was the time God loved the world so much that he said, "Let me give my son." Today, millions are born again because of that blessing. If not Jesus giving, you and I will not be here today. We are the result of that seed. If you continue to give change, whether in the house of God or out there, God will also give you change. Change is something we don't need. The Bible says when you give, you will abound with more grace. More grace. Have you considered how many people are fasting 21 days, 40 days for something and they don't get? Give and it shall be given unto you. Fasting is to humble ourselves, not to try to twist the hand of God. You want to bribe God? You want to bribe Father? If you want to receive, you must give. Because giving, it is the only way to multiply whatever we have received from God. If you want more strength, give your strength. If you want more love, give more love. If you want money, give more money. If you want caring, continue to care more. Do you know that if God opens your eyes to see why certain things happen to your life, you will stop bothering yourself. You will stop complaining. Consider the story of a man who was praying to God to give him money so that he can go and buy shoes. He prayed earnestly for God to give him money. One day, God decided to give the man the money, go and buy shoes. You have been disturbing. The man, on his way to the shop, he met a man without limbs, a man without legs. The man started appreciating God even without shoes. He started realizing that whatever condition you are in, whatever position you are in, somebody wants to be where you are. Can I ever say, whatever position you are, somebody wants to be where you are now. And you are also complaining, crying to be somewhere, but there's someone who just wants to be where you are. If they can be where you are, they will give glory to God. So which means we should learn to give glory to God, no matter the condition, the position we are, knowing that somebody wants to be where I am. A cheerful giver. God loves a cheerful giver. God loves a cheerful giver. Yes.